Example three, using a table of values, we're going to graph y equals negative x squared plus 4. So we're going to look what happens when we have a negative sign in front of our x squared, and now we've got a plus 4 in here as well. So we're going to fill in a table of values. So again, we're going to continue to use negative 2 to 2. So y equals negative, plug in negative 2 squared plus 4. So this negative sign here is out front of the brackets. You plugged in a negative number, that's in the bracket. So you square negative 2, but this negative sign is still out front at first. So negative 2 squared is 4. So you have negative 4 plus 4, which is 0. So that's your first number. I'll maybe show my work one more time with those negatives. So I'm plugging in negative 1 now. So I'm going to have negative, negative 1 squared is positive 1 plus 4. I'm going to get 3. Plug in 0, 0 squared 0, so 0 plus 4, you're going to get 4. Plug in 1, similar stuff's going to happen here. You're going to get negative 1 plus 4 equals 3. Plug in 2, 2 squared is 4, so negative 4 plus 4 is 0. So let's plot this. So x-axis first, negative 2 and 0, so that's right on the x-axis. That'll be an x-intercept. Negative 1, 3, 0, 4. 1, 3, 2, 0. So what you'll notice is our nice U shape still, not too rigid. It's a smooth curve. Arrows, because it would continue in that direction. So always put arrows at the ends of your parabolas. This is an upside down parabola. And what's made an upside down parabola is this negative sign in front. So as we move forward, you're going to start to notice that when there's a negative sign in front of the x squared, that's going to go upside down. So let's have a look, and this plus 4 actually made it shift up 4. We'll look at that again too. So again, good idea to pause this video to fill in the features of the parabola so you can practice on your own, then hit play again to see the answers. Okay, so hopefully you have filled this in. The domain has still been all of the possible x values, so it's negative infinity to positive infinity. The range now, it's everything below 4. So it's actually negative infinity to 4 with a square bracket. It includes 4. You can also say y is less than or equal to negative 4 if you used set notation. The x-intercepts across at negative 2 and positive 2. So x is equal to negative 2, 2, or you can write it as plus or minus 2. The y-intercept is at 4. So y equals 4. The minimum value, there is no minimum, there's no lowest point, so none, but it has a max now. So the highest point's at 4 on the y-axis, so we say y equals 4. Remember, that has to be an equation, you need the equal sign. The vertex is written as an ordered pair, it's this point, 0, 4. Make sure you have brackets around that ordered pair. Equation of the axis of symmetry, so the line that would cut it in half would be here, it's still x equals 0. We keep drawing the parabola on the y-axis, so that's why that hasn't changed, but it will down the road. And zeros are the same thing as your x-intercept. So x equals negative 2 or 2, or you can write it as plus or minus 2.